Hello homebrewers and welcome to Homebrew Wild and Cheap. So today we are outside in my walk-in larder. And what we're going to be picking are these. These are the tips of stinging nettles. Lovely. Now they do have stingers on, so I advise you wearing gloves. But I'm hardcore, so I'm not going to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a carrier bag's worth of these tiny little tips on the end, because they're the sweetest and the juiciest, and I'll meet you back in the house, where I won't be glaring at the sun. Catch you in a bit. So we have made it back into the house. Now I have my carrier bag of nettles. Lovely, lovely. I got some strange looks while I was picking this, but my other half was there too, so she got the strange looks as well. So one carrier bag of the very tips of a stinging nettle. Now my fingers, just these three fingers, got stung quite a lot. So after a couple of minutes of being stung, you don't notice it. Turns out. Who knew? Now you do as well. So, for this nettle beer recipe, we're going to mix things up. Not only am I going to be using an excessive amount of orange juice, so I actually went and bought juice from concentrate. This was 55 pence. I had a bag of lemons because I had a cold the other week. So this is a lemon left, just to add some actual, you know, lemon in it. And I have hops. Actual hops. Now, this particular brand of hops is called Citra. It is very citrusy, has a very mild bittering at the end. So hopefully this is going to turn out kind of like a very, very fruity IPA. Without that dishwater taste. Fingers crossed. So, the batch I'm making is a gallon batch, but I'm going overboard on the orange juice because I really like oranges. So that's why I bought it from concentrate. Otherwise, I'd have to spend maybe 6 or 8 pounds on oranges just to squeeze them to put them in because I like lots of citrus. So this is what I'm going to be using. It's a bit of an experiment and a mishmash, but hopefully this is going to be the most fantastic nettle beer ever made. Sure, why not? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get all the things I need to set up, like the pan in the back and my little cooker, and then we'll be right back. Right, so here is pretty much everything we are going to need. So I have my one carrier bag of nettles, pretty nice. Now I have cut this version down from a 5 gallon batch, because normally they say about 4 carrier bags, and yeah, that's about right. This is just under one-ish, it's not completely full, so that should be plenty. Fresh nettles. When using my usual 5 litre water container, which is Ashbeck from Tesco's, costs £1.10, and I'm just going to use the old thing here. Why not? It's a pound. So free, £1. My orange juice. This was 55p for a litre. Now, even though this is kind of smooth and cheap, this is going to froth and it's going to puke out bits. It just happens. There are bits in this. Then we're going to be adding our hops. Now I'm going to add these about 5 minutes towards the end, so it isn't too bittering. And hopefully this will give a very nice body and flavor, which you don't get if you just add lemon and lime. And right at the end, when I've taken this off the heat, I'm going to add the juice of a lemon, not the rind or anything. Hopefully the hops are going to take the place of everything. And this is going to be, hopefully, a nice beer. Fingers crossed. Now, the great thing about the orange juice is that it already contains sugars. So per 250ml, it has 23 grams of sugar. So I'm hoping that this is not going to need any extra sugar adding in. I do have sugar on standby, but we will find out. As well, I'll be using my hydrometer, which is here, which I will need to sterilize. The water bottle, I don't. So it's fairly straightforward. Put this down here. I'm going to take my orange juice, I'm going to add it straight in. I could just add it at the end, but why not? It doesn't harm. And as you can see, love the orange juice. Lovely, lovely. Now I'm going to put my gas hob on. Oh yeah, nice, good rolling heat. Now you can use more orange juice, depending on how much citrus you like. And like I said, I am kind of lazy, so instead of buying a large quantity of oranges, I'm using orange juice. It's cheaper. May not be quite as good, but still, it's orange juice. It's all good. Now, I'm going to use some of the water in my demijohn slash water container to add to this, because I don't want to waste any. But basically, in goes all of these nettles. Yeah, they've already been fresh picked. They're going to be sterilized in the boil. So add them in. Oh, it stings. They're still fresh. They're less than an hour and a half old. And they've already been sorted. So there's one bag. And here is the other. Now, if any of you are interested in what a nettle looks like up close, here is a picture. Oh yeah, that's nice. Looking good. In it goes. And a blade of grass. Now, I only picked at the freshest tips, and my other half seems to have picked half the field. But that's fair enough. A little bit of grass in there adds flavor. Whatever. It adds flavor, why not? So, my lovely demijohn, water bottle. And now I'm just gonna pour half of this water right in here for the boil. About half. Put the lid back on. Now hopefully I shouldn't need to re-sterilize this. Famous last words. I shouldn't need to re-sterilize this. I'm going to keep picking out these little blades of grass that she's put in there. Extra flavor. Mainly because it's only been open and it's going to be open for a little bit. This is all going to be sterilized and boiled. That's pretty cool. So now I've got to wait till it comes up to the boil, and then I'll leave it to boil for about 20 minutes. I'll see you in 20 minutes, guys. So, it is now 15 minutes in. This has come to a nice boil. There's sort of a scum that you get when you're cooking nettles up. It's like a frothy scum. It happens. This is why I used a very big pan, because I knew that nettles do this, because I have cooked with nettles, so I know that it does do this. So, 5 minutes from the end. I've got myself a measured quantity of the citra hops. Lovely, lovely. These are in pellet form. They look interesting. They do smell kind of citrusy. They do smell citrusy, so hopefully this is going to be fantastic. So, just going to pop these in. Fairly simple. And since we're so close to the end, I've got my strainer. See, I'm going up in the world. I actually have a strainer. This is made of plastic, so acids such as lemon juice don't affect it. Ooh, that smells really good. It's kind of weird because the hops are related to cannabis or weed or whatever you want to call it, so it does have a kind of weedy smell. Since nettles are weeds. Funny, right? Anyway, so I'm going to strain in my lemon juice now. And hopefully these hops are going to take the place for the large amount of things that I didn't add in. Now, I do believe that I'm going to have to adjust it with sugar. That just happens. I was just thinking about it in my head, and I only added in 1 liter of orange juice. So, you know, it's around, call it 25 grams of sugar per 250 ml. That's only 100 grams that are going into a gallon, so that's a very low alcohol brew. Well, that smells really good. It kind of smelled a little orangey from the orange juice, but now it smells citrusy. Hints of weed, let's put it into there. And you can't really smell the orange or the lemon I've just added in. But it does smell interesting, I will give it that. Oh, that's on the nose. Ugh. Okay, that's hot, but it smells good, and I'm facializing myself with steam. So this is basically going to be on for another couple of minutes and I'm going to turn it off. So I'll be back then. So the 5 minutes of boiling is now up, it is shut off. And we now have a very hot, smelly goo now. We have, actually smells really good. I'm very surprised considering I'm not really a fan of nettle brews. So, personal experience. So this actually smells very citrusy. It is grapefruit, orange, which I expected from the juice in there. It does have hints of citrus, but not specifically lemon or lime. It's just floral and citrus all at the same time. It smells really, really good. That smell of kind of weed has burnt off. That must have just been as it was, you know, hydrating. It's all the same member of the same family. So now we have pretty much a couple of liters of hot brew. So I'm going to rapid chill this, the only way I know how. I've got my pan and I've got my sink filled with ice cold water, or as cold as it comes out the tap. And I'm just literally going to dump this in for half an hour. So yeah, this is what I'm going to do. Now that is the quickest way that I can think to chill down about 3 liters of very, very hot nettles and water and orange juice. So yeah, I'll be back in 30 minutes and we can see if it's cooled down enough to put it in this demijohn and see if we need to adjust it with sugar. So I'll see you in 30 minutes. Awesome. Hey, so it has been 30 minutes. Oh yeah, and it is now cool enough to hold onto and touch. So it's still quite warm, but that's okay because we're going to be watering it down. And here is my demijohn. I've taken off the label. I have sterilized my hydrometer, my funnel. And this was already pre-sterilized because I used it for the lemons. So now should be the fun task. I'm going to take my funnel, stick her in. I'm going to put my other one on the top. See, learning. This is going to be a two-handed job, always. And now I'm going to literally start pouring the chunks out of this. Oh, this is going to be fun with one hand. And just straining the vast majority of all the nettly chunks out. And because I don't want them in. And hopefully most of the hops are going to stay in my filter. Relatively easy task. I've jinxed myself now. Now there's some nettles in there, it holds it all down. Hold on to this with my strong hand and I will use my other hand, which has also been sterilized because I've been using the bleach, and give this a nice squish. You don't have to worry about it stinging you because once it's boiled, all of the ampules of silica, which are like little teeny tiny hypodermics like you saw, they all kind of explode and pop. So all of that, weirdly, all of that poison goes into the liquid. I don't understand. Maybe it will make it fantastic once it's fermented. But either way, that is now pretty much a good blob, like so. Smells good though. There we go. So I'm going to top this up, move this out of the way, once this is finished draining. There we go. I'm going to top it up to about here. Then I'm going to test it with a hydrometer. Now, if I vaguely have a clue what's going on, I only added in 1 liter of orange juice. So that should mean this is a very low percentage. Maybe, I don't know, let's take a look. So it should be, it says medium, it's not even a percentage, but it'll be around 2-3%. And I want to bump that up to a respectable 5-ish. 5% is always good for any beer. So I have pre-measured out 400 grams, because I'm hoping that the last little bit in here will make it up to about 5%. There's only one way to find out, and that's to do it. Off to the top up. So as you can see, it's sort of like a dirty orange colour. That's because the nettles and the orange juice, which has still has bits in it, which will settle out. So this has been turned over. Let's rinse it. Let's see what this says. Funny enough, it's about 2-3%. Not what we're after. Which is a bit of a shame, so now I've got to use my sugar, as we use the funnel, and try and pour this straight in. If you used a lot more orange juice, like 3 or 4 liters of orange juice, you'd have, funny enough, somewhere around the 9% mark, but the hops are supposedly going to give it a very, very nice hoppy flavor, so I wanted to reduce it and just use lots of oranges in the form of orange juice. 1, I'm lazy. 2, I'm cheap. And 3, hopefully these hops are going to do a fantastic job. So yeah, just take this out. Since this is still warm, I'll just keep it in the... still a little warm, but that's cool. Let's give this a good shake, and let's see if we can't get a pretty good estimate. Nope, still needs more shaking. How are we doing? It's looking pretty good. So let's see what percentage this should hopefully come out at. Just let the bubbles clear and then we will check. So it has been a couple of minutes that I've been talking to myself before I noticed that my batteries in my camera had died. So I had to change them, and we've come back and it's almost the end of the video. So I went away and I got my yeast out of the fridge. Now this is the lager yeast that I got from the beer kit once we siphoned all the stuff out. I've been keeping it in the fridge at just above zero in fresh water. Seems to work, so this is having recycled yeast, so I don't really have to spend out on yeast, but you could use a bread yeast. Just saying you could, it is a beer. So the final hydrometer reading once we added in our 400 grams of sugar was 6.5%, otherwise known as 1.40. Yeah, that's 1.40, I suppose. But yeah, it's 1.40. Potential alcohol, lovely, lovely. So, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna put this by my radiator and keep it nice and warm. And hopefully, if everything turns out okay, this should take about the same time as a beer kit, so 21 days. That's pretty awesome, from start to finish. So we're going to put this by the radiator and leave it for a week, and then I'm going to start the part two of the video. So you can see me doing the other bits and that all in one bulk bit. It's just how I do stuff. So I will see you for the part two of this video in about a month's time. Awesome, we like waiting a month. So, I hope you found this video interesting. It is a little bit of a different take on the usual nettle beer. So, yeah, comment, rate, subscribe, and share. I mean, more people that view these recipes and comment and stuff, the, you know, the bigger the community we can have. So, take care, guys, and I'll see you in another video.